Normally, buildings are constructed with a set amount of materials, budget, and plans. However, masterpieces may need more than what was initially asked of them. Get ready to be blown away as we take a ride through the stories behind some iconic structures that broke through their initial budgets. These are seven of the world's most remarkable construction marvels that went over budget. Let's start with the stunning Sagrada Familia in Barcelona, Spain, designed by the one and only Antoni Gaudí circa 1882. The Sagrada Familia is a large Roman Catholic church located in Barcelona, Spain, renowned for its unique architectural style, blending elements of Gothic and Art Nouveau design, its intricate stone carvings, and colorful stained glass windows. This architectural masterpiece has been under construction for a whopping 141 years. What's even more impressive is that it's not funded by the government or the church. Rather, it's backed up by private patrons and tourism ticket sales. With a budget that started at 12 million euros, it ended up expanding to 500 million euros, over 40 times the initial budget. Gaudí passed away in 1926 before the project was completed, leaving behind some complex designs that were challenging for the construction workers to fully understand. Then, as if that wasn't enough, the Spanish Civil War and the Great Depression added to the delays, making funding pretty scarce. The models required to make Gaudí's dream a reality were made by hand, at least until 2001, when more advanced techniques such as 3D printing were used. This was done to make things easier and true to Gaudí's plan. However, this didn't quite help because the team of Jordi Fali, the current head architect and manager of the church's construction, is still pushing to modify Gaudí's plans due to its innate difficulty, such as the esplanade that connects it to the diagonal avenue. This move was then sarcastically quoted by Councilman of Barcelona Architecture, Urban Landscape and Heritage, Daniel Modó, as a project without plans in Gaudí's name. Bureaucracy has also played a part in this delay, as the church's trustees never had a building permit in the first place. Thus, they were hit with a staggering $41 million fine, a tab generated from over a century of delinquent non-payment. Furthermore, when it was time to buy the new permit, pushing the project to completion, it became the most expensive on record, a whopping $5.2 million. Nevertheless, this unfinished masterpiece was recognized as a UNESCO World Heritage Site and has become one of Barcelona's top tourist attractions. Today, it receives around 20 million visitors annually, a testament to Gaudí's genius. In essence, this piece of architecture has been a beautiful disaster. The Sagrada Familia is set to be complete in 2026, 144 years after it started construction. Now, let's head underground to the Chunnel, a 37.9-kilometer tunnel that connects England and France. What you may not know is that this engineering marvel had its fair share of setbacks, with a budget that started at 4.7 billion euros and ended up at an eye-watering 13.8 billion euros. The culprit was the tunneling machine used to dig the tunnel, which broke down multiple times, causing significant delays and adding to the costs. Also, there was the problem of chalk. Engineers had to dig through layers of chalk, which was supposed to be a stable foundation for the tunnel. However, they soon discovered that the chalk was riddled with faults and fissures, which caused the tunnel to leak. It was an expensive 150 million pound problem to fix and divert the tunnel to stronger foundations. Additionally, the initial budget didn't include the cost of safety features and equipment, hence the whopping 293.6% increase from the initial budget. What's more disturbing is that the economic analysis of the project has shown that the channel tunnel cannot be considered a success due to the large amount of resources invested in its construction. This means that the impact of the mistakes made during construction could be felt for years to come, as public funds are diverted from other important projects to cover the costs of the tunnel. But the Chunnel has become a crucial part of transportation. Despite the continuous volley of problems, they still made it through. While we're still in the area, let's talk about the Millau Viaduct in France, the tallest bridge in the world. This beauty stands tall at 343 meters with a starting budget of 300 million euros. However, it would seem that it had other plans to rise sky high with the budget too, because it ended up at a heart-stopping 400 million euros. And it's all because of failed planning. The construction team switched from a cable-stayed bridge to a suspension bridge, which led to additional costs that exceeded the initial budget. They also had to use a technique called post-tensioning to increase the weight limit of the bridge too, implying that the bridge wasn't originally designed to handle heavier loads. Don't let the issues scare you though. The Millau Viaduct has become a massive tourist attraction and a vital part of transportation in the region. Next up is the Panama Canal, a busy and successful waterway connecting the Atlantic and Pacific Oceans. However, with a construction budget that skyrocketed from $359 million to $7.7 billion, it's safe to say that its origins had a rocky start. For context, the French started the project in 1881, but failed to complete it due to financial and engineering issues. The United States then took over in 1904, but they faced their own set of challenges, including difficult terrain and rampant disease. There was also the problem of hiring cheaper contractors for the expansion project. What's sad, though, is that the construction mistakes of the Panama Canal had a significant impact on the workers involved in the project. Despite being a tremendous American achievement, the health costs to the mostly Caribbean contract workers were staggering. As per the reports of April 18, 2018, workers suffered massively while working on the canal. It's reported that around 25,000 workers lost their lives during its construction, which is an alarming figure. Many workers were injured or maimed due to accidents or illnesses that they contracted while working on the canal. Despite all that, we know that the Panama Canal has proved its usefulness over the years. It's become a vital part of the global trade scenery, much like the Suez Canal is in Egypt. Just last year, in 2022, the Panama Canal recorded a sum of 14,239 voyages made by vessels of varying sizes, carrying a total of 291 million tons of merchandise. Now, let's cross the Pacific and stumble upon the Sydney Opera House. This iconic structure is a real showstopper, but with a budget that ballooned from $7 million to $102 million Australian dollars, it was clear that there were some major disagreements between the construction team and the designer within the 14-year span it was built. The construction process itself presented technical challenges that added to the costs. They also somehow got the opera house and stage production halls switched, bungling the acoustics up. From structural flaws to the complete redesigning of its roof, government officials were raised with a question on accountability for the said project's failures. Despite the overblown budget, the Sydney Opera House has become a major tourist attraction, is listed as a UNESCO World Heritage Site, and stands tall as a symbol of Australian pride. Now, heading back stateside, let's go to the Nevada-Arizona border, to the ever-so-famous Hoover Dam. No official figures state its originally planned cost, but it had a final cost of $49 million, which, when converted to today's money, is a whopping $905 million. The initial design had the vulnerability of tipping over, and the dam's foundation had to be extensively modified. In addition, the concrete mix initially used for the project proved to be inadequate, leading to delays and additional costs. The delays were also caused by multiple labor issues. Workers suffered from carbon monoxide poisoning and other health issues due to poor ventilation and the irony of unsafe safety measures at the time. The construction of the Hoover Dam also had several negative impacts on the environment. One of the main effects was the lowering of the riverbed, which caused the groundwater table to gradually become deeper. This change in water levels had an impact on the local ecosystem, including the surrounding vegetation and wildlife. Additionally, the dam's construction led to the displacement of several native species in the area. If the Hoover Dam were to be removed, four species of sturgeons and egrets would benefit from the restoration of their natural habitat. It's safe to say that the dam's construction cost was too expensive for the time, both in monetary and environmental aspects. In the end, it's all water under the bridge, as the Hoover Dam is now a powerhouse of hydroelectric energy and irrigation for the region. As of February 24th of 2023, Hoover Dam generates around 4 billion kilowatt hours of hydroelectric power per year for usage in 675,000 households across Nevada, Arizona, and California. Speaking of dam mistakes, we have the Three Gorges Dam in China, a massive endeavor designed to cost $22.5 billion but ended up costing a whopping $37 billion. The construction of this dam had its fair share of rocky moments, with technical challenges adding to the cost and environmental concerns, causing some serious waves downstream. Former Premier Zhu Rongji accused the construction companies of shoddy engineering, prompting revision after revision. The dam's construction also caused significant ecological and social problems, including the displacement of over 1.4 million people and the loss of wildlife habitats of 400 species, such as the extremely endangered Yangtze River dolphin. There was also an increase in landslides and earthquakes in the region. It's the ultimate earthshaker. Moreover, there's a perceived risk of the dam failing, displacing 1.3 million more people living downstream and causing widespread devastation. This risk has been a significant concern since the dam's construction, and experts have warned that the dam's weight and water pressure could lead to a structural failure, leading to further loss of life. The worrying part here is that there's no specific information to suggest that China is currently taking any specific measures to prevent the Three Gorges Dam from collapsing. According to a statement made by China Yangtze Power, the company that operates the dam, July 18, 2020, the dam is, quote, functioning normally and is serving to prevent flood disasters. However, historical records show otherwise. The Banqiao Dam, along with 61 other dams in Henan, China, in 1975, collapsed when Typhoon Nina dumped record-breaking levels of rainfall, causing 175,000 people downstream to lose their lives. The authorities back then also did nothing. Furthermore, a report from August 11th of 2021 warned that China's many dams could increase flooding risks for downstream communities as intense rainfall becomes more common. More water, more pressure, more risk for collapse. But China is definitely powering through this crucial hydroelectric energy source that could serve up to 5.4 million households, despite the $14.5 billion overspending and the expensive loss of human livelihoods and animal habitats. As we've seen, the construction industry has the power to create remarkable wonders that push the limits of what's possible. These projects may have exceeded their budgets, but they've also exceeded our expectations, inspiring us with their beauty, innovation, and resilience. These marvels now produce electricity for us, strike awe, promote culture, and help us reach places we've never dreamed of before. Let's continue to celebrate and learn from these achievements and use them as a source of motivation to keep pushing forward and reaching new heights. This is our future planet.